Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In this session, we will discuss the exam style questions from the topic of general properties of waves from IGCSE and O level physics. Here in the first question, we have given a figure 3.13, and this figure gives a full scale representation of water in a ripple tank. So this wave is produced in a ripple tank 1 second after the vibrator was started. So vibrator started here and it produced this kind of waves. So these lines are all crest. So we have obtained from the demonstration setup this kind of observations. And what is represented at A, at this point A, at this instant? The color lines represents the crust. So this blue lines are crust. So this is between two crust is a trough. So this red point is representing a trough. In a B part, determine the wavelength. So wavelength is the distance between two crust is the wavelength. So here we can see that the two distance between the two consecutive identical points, such as two consecutive crust, is 0.5 centimeters. So this is the difference between the two crust anywhere is 0.5 centimeter. So the wavelength is 0.5 centimeter. Now the speed, since it takes 5 wavelength in 1 second. So the speed of the wave in the distance moved in the direction of travel of the wave by a crust or any other point of the wave in 1 second. So this is the definition of wave speed. So we actually multiply the wavelength with frequency. So in our case, we have a wavelength is 0.5 centimeters. So this is 0.5 centimeter, and the frequency is because it takes 5 wavelength in 1 second. So the frequency is 5 hertz. So this is 5 hertz. So when multiply this, you will get this 2.5 centimeters per second. So this is the wavelength and the frequency of the vibrator. Since there are 5 waves in 1 second, therefore the frequency is 5 hertz. Now describe a suitable attachment which could have been vibrated up and down to produce this wave pattern. Produced through a ripple tank demonstration setup, as discussed earlier, like kind of setup may be used. So this is the question number 2. In a transverse wave shown in figure 3.14, distances are in centimeters. So this is distance and this is displacement. Which pair of entries A to D is correct? So this is our mean position, and from mean position to the peak is called the amplitude. So the amplitude is from 4 to 8 is, so the amplitude is 4 and wavelength is from this 0 to 8. So so the wavelength is 8. So wavelength is 8 and amplitude is 4. So this C is correct. C is correct because the amplitude is 4 and the wavelength is 8. Second part, when a water wave goes from deep to a shallow water, the changes, if any, in its wave is speed, wavelength and frequencies are. So the change in the direction of travel of the waves which occurs when there is speed and hence wavelength changes. If wavelength changes, speed changes. So if wavelength decreases in a shallow water, then the speed will decrease like this. So the answer is B. So this speed will decrease. In a part C, copy figure this and show on it what happened to the wave as they pass through the gap. So these are the waves that is passing through this narrow gap. If the water is much shallower on the right side, this is shallower region, and after that is a deep region. on the right side of the gap. So the gap, if the water is much shallower on the right side of the gap than on the left. So this side is deeper and this side is shallower. So when this passes through this gap, this will bend, this wave will bend at the edges, and we will get this kind of curve here. And since we are moving from shallow region to the deep region, so this wavelength will increase. So the distance between this crest will increase, and the speed will also increase. So this is a diffraction phenomena will occur for a narrow gap setup. So this is very important. So this is all. In the next session, we will discuss.